Tuesday afternoon.
Monday. We are cooking with Kyle today, and he is helping us with our sweet tooth today. These peanut butter cookies are easy to make, and they are his favorite peanut butter cookie recipe. And for a chef to say that, that means they're pretty special. Brand new recipe for us. So tell us about it.
What you got? Oh my gosh. Well, okay, they're my new favorite. And cookies for me are just like kind of like pizza for some people. They can't be that bad. But this is amazing. It's quick. It's easy. Our final product started with 32. Mm-hmm. We're now down to a dozen. Now, I did have a couple of taste testers, but then someone ate quite a few, 13 to be exact. I don't know who that is.
Oh, my gosh. Well, it's whoever has a stomach ache in your family.
And Chef John Bennett pronounced these. He got one so that we would still have a dozen for KFOR, and he pronounced them the best he's ever had.
Okay. Well, for him and you to say that, they're amazing.
We've already started. We've creamed one stick of butter. To this, we're going to add a half of a cup of peanut butter. Now, I'm going to tell you also, you can double this recipe, but this recipe will make 32 about 3-inch cookies. And obviously, for someone like me, I don't need to be making any more than that because I would probably eat them. In fact, there's really not a probably there. We'll just mix these together. And then to our peanut butter and butter, we will add a half cup brown sugar.
Half cup brown sugar.
Well, if I can get it. There we go.
You know, I've noticed that ever since that you let me salt and pepper something and I dumped it all in one spot, you haven't let me mix anything ever since then.
Well, and you know what? Since we don't have a stand mixer, I have to be careful on the air. Okay, we're gonna add another half cup, a half cup of white sugar.
Half cup white sugar.
And we're gonna add an egg.
And an egg.
And
okay.
An egg. Okay.
Did you get any shell in there?
No. I'm good.
Just checking.
All right, now what we do is we'll mix this until it's actually kind of fluffy looking.
Okay.
And we're almost there. All right, fluffy, fluffy. Now, to this, we are going to fold in about a cup of flour, and I've already mixed into this a half teaspoon of soda.
Okay.
And we will fold those ingredients together until well mixed. And then we get to what I consider to be the most important part, which of course would be the chocolate chips.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm using both white and dark chocolate, but you could use all white or all dark. You could omit them entirely.
What's the secret ingredient? Is that it?
Well, there's really not. The secret is the texture of them is a little bit lighter. They're not quite as dense as most peanut butter cookies, which I like.
Okay.
And really, I don't know that I would say that there's a secret to it other than we're giving it away here.
Okay. So last ingredient.
One cup. I used a half a cup each. Mm-hmm. Don't be chintzy with the chocolate chips.
Don't eat the bag before you put them in.
And from there, we're ready to go. Preheat the oven to 325. It's very important that you do not overbake these.
Okay.
And part of it, you're going to get some that were slightly... No, don't try that one.
What's wrong with that one? I want this one.
Okay, fine. You can have whatever you want. They will not turn golden on the top. And when they are just starting to crisp on the sides, that's when to pull them from the oven. 32, about this size.
Okay. All right, here goes.
Try it out.
That's really good.
There you go.
Why wouldn't we? Yes, Chef Bennett was right, and you are right.
My favorite new cookie.
Very good. Of course, you can find this recipe on our website at KFOR.com.